Hey guys, it's O3 Instructor. Today, I went out and I got one of these Troy medieval muzzle brakes. I've been looking at these things for quite a while, and if you know anything about me, I tend to look a lot before I buy. And, you know, I've been looking at other people's reviews and videos and all that good stuff, and I've even seen some on the range perform. And I tell you what, I kind of like this this Troy medieval muzzle brake. I really like the design of it. I like the features of it. I like how they're incorporating the muzzle brake, but they got it in a way to where it doesn't look like a regular traditional muzzle brake. I like the spikes on the front so you can strike somebody, you know, or bust a glass with it. I probably wouldn't use it for that, but, you know, a little different things. I like the craftsmanship of it. Very nice product. Very nice product, and I'm extremely happy with this. As you all know, a muzzle brake, all it does is forces the gases in certain directions, like up to the sides, up, what have you. Some of them are just off to the sides, and it reduces recoil and muzzle rise. And that's one reason. I give you a good example of how a muzzle brake can really help the recoil on a gun. The 50 cal sniper rifle that the Marine Corps uses, the Sasser, that thing is awesome to shoot, and they don't really have that much recoil. If you ever shot one, it's a blast to shoot, because that muzzle brake disperses so much energy. You know, that thing would be awful to fire without a muzzle brake. So for a gun like a 5.56 caliber gun, having a muzzle brake on there, that's just going to enhance your shooting, you know, capabilities even more. Some people want a flash suppressor. To me, it really doesn't matter, because in every combat situation I've been in, everybody knows you're there. Engagement most of the time is by choice of the enemy. They engage you, you react, you know, and you take care of business. If you're doing a raid, time you bust down the door, they know you're there. You know, if you're doing your shooting, all of that good stuff, it's... To me, maybe it's not a good idea maybe on a sniper rifle, because that's something where you really, really need to keep a concealed position. But especially for three gunning, home defense, things like that, I mean, I don't see no problem with a muzzle brake. I mean, hell, I wish I had a muzzle brake on mine when I was in Iraq, you know. But I just had a regular flash suppressor on my M4. So that's my take on muzzle brakes. You know, it's a big... people start arguing and all that kind of stuff. If I'm getting rounds down range and they're hitting the target, I mean, I don't know. To me, that's pretty important. Target can't shoot back if you're hitting it. Moving right along. The instructions are pretty simple to utilize. For me, I use my... Let me get that so you guys see it. I use my AR tool wrench that I got with my rifle. This is a Delton DTI rifle, and they include this, well, at that time, they included it with the rifle for free, along with 5 metal mags and a nice case. I don't know if every manufacturer include one of those tools with the rifle, but, you know, it's kind of a nice thing to have, so when you get accessories, you can just pop them right on, no problem. Instructions are clear cut, easy to do. If you don't have an AR tool like I got, you can, it says just use a three-fourths inch opening wrench, and it comes with the crush washer, so you don't have to reuse the one you had on there. Or if you didn't have one, whatever the problem may be, you know, they include everything you need, and I'm extremely happy with it. I like the look of it. It's a little bit longer than I thought, but you know, it looks all right. I think it looks sexy, and I can't wait to take this out to the range and test it out, along with my other accessories that I got. All right, guys, I'm out.